Hi everyone, welcome back to the Coffee Corner. We want to continue with our article, Adventure Racing.
It's a sport, what we're talking about. This sport is growing in popularity very quickly.
Mm-hmm. And I think that's probably because it's not only fun, but it's challenging and it's interesting.
That's right, it is very interesting. We want to learn more about it right now. Join us in the right-hand column on page 29.
The contestants have to be in peak physical condition and must be familiar with many different outdoor sports. These athletes also need to have superior stamina. Typical adventure races take several days to complete, and the courses often cover hundreds of miles. Adventure races are definitely not for the faint of heart. The surprise factor of adventure races also appeals to contestants. Before the teams start racing, they have no knowledge of the route they're supposed to take.
Well, we know this is a contest, and if you have a contest, you have to have contestants. Those are the people in the contest, so it says the contestants have to be in peak physical condition, and that's not easy to do because you're talking about being in totally perfect, almost, condition, right?
Right, and not only physical condition, but as you mentioned earlier, they also have to be in peak condition mentally, too, because they have to know a lot of information about a lot of different sports.
Right, and when we talk about a peak, we might think of a mountain. The top of a mountain is called the peak. So here we just mean top physical and mental condition, or peak condition.
That's right. If they want to perform well or have peak performance in these events, they have to be in good condition, perfect condition, or as best as possible, right? And it says they must be familiar with many of the different outdoor sports. So they have to be, as you said, aware of these sports. They have to know about them. You can't just go out there and say, yeah, I'm going to ride a bicycle. You have to know something about really riding and competing riding.
Especially when you're riding a bicycle on these mountains and down through muddy trails and the places that they're riding them, it just wouldn't be smart to go out there and try to do these races without being familiar with how to do them.
So you're saying I probably shouldn't do this.
Well, not only you, as Anna and I are learning, we have to train too. I wouldn't be doing some of these activities either.
Well, I think if I was in an adventure race that had rock climbing, I would be very scared. I don't know how to do it. I would have to learn how. Mm-hmm. And then I think of being in very high places and needing to be in a hurry. That seems very dangerous to me.
And I think we have to remember these are athletes, right? These are people who are athletes. They are involved in many sports, probably, or at least one they're very familiar with. And it takes some time. They have to get familiar with the others before they compete in this race.
Yeah, they have to have the physical condition, like we mentioned. They have to have knowledge of the sport. They have to understand it. And these two things working together give them stamina so that they can last for a long period of time, because these races are not short races.
And because they are athletes, they probably are in better physical condition, so they will have this stamina. Notice it says superior stamina.
Right, superior, over and above many other people or many other things, to be superior. Now, of course, when we talk about stamina, it's that physical and mental energy that you need to do something for a very long time. I think about marathon runners running 23 or 26 miles. It takes a lot of stamina to keep on running.
Yeah, that's the key, to keep on running. We may be able to run a short distance, but do we have the stamina to endure the whole race?
And Anna, you mentioned a marathoner. They have to go 26 miles, just a little bit more than 26 miles. Well, in our article, we find out that these adventure races sometimes go over several days and cover several, or at least 100 miles.
Amazing.
Superior stamina.
Actually, it says hundreds of miles, so there is an S there. there. Yeah. 100 might be a little better, right?
Sure. Yeah.
So typical adventure races take several days to complete, and the courses often cover hundreds of miles. So this idea of covering hundreds of miles is this is the course, this is the area that they actually use for the race.
That's right, and we can see that you need to be pretty strong and pretty adventurous to be able to make it through one of these races.
You can't be faint of heart.
That's right.
Yeah, and people that are faint of heart are people who are easily scared or easily made afraid. They lack the courage mm-hmm. to be able to do things that require them to have courage, I guess. They don't have that courage, as you mentioned earlier. To be in a high place with just ropes holding you on the edge of a cliff takes courage. I'm not sure I could do it.
Well, I know that I couldn't because I don't like heights, right? Yeah. So for the faint of heart, high places usually are not places we like to be.
Okay, well, not only should you be in top physical condition and mental condition, but also you're probably looking for adventure and the surprise factor that comes along with these adventure races.
And our article says that this surprise factor appeals to a lot of the people that are in the races. Mm-hmm. Not only do they want to be challenged physically and mentally, not only do they want to prove that they aren't faint of heart or weak and not able to do this, but they want to be surprised. They want to go into a situation where they really don't have any idea of how it's going to end up.
And as we started this article and talked about the title, Adventure, right, we did say that adventure means that there are unexpected things that happen. And this is something that some people enjoy. They like the idea that I'm going to face things that I didn't expect. There are going to be some surprises along the way. But hey, I can handle it.
Yeah. Now, if you're running a marathon, usually you'll know how long it will be. You'll probably get a map in the mail so you know where you'll run, if there will be hills or not hills. But these people that are in the adventure races don't know their course before they start.
In fact, our article here says they have no knowledge of the route they're supposed to take. Maybe they only know where they're supposed to show up at city or the location, mm-hmm. and they have no idea where they're going to go from there or how they're going to get there.
Right. So I guess the only way they can really prepare is by trying different sports, right, and getting in top physical condition and telling themselves, hey, I can face these different obstacles that will come up along the way. So who knows? Maybe you can put on your own little mini adventure race, right, and throw some adventure in there and prepare yourself that way. Looks like we're out of time. We want to review today's lesson. Next time we'll come back and talk more about adventure racing.
Hi, 大家好，我是 Michelle。今天第一个要看的是有关竞赛的几个名词。首先来看的是 competition， 它是从 compete 竞争或比赛这个动词衍生出来的。之前我们有提过 ，competition 是泛指一般的竞赛或竞争，而参赛者或竞争者就是 competitor，C O M P E T I T O R。注意它第一个 T 的后面变成 I 而不是 E。另外一个和竞赛有关的字是 contest， 所竞争的项目常常和运动的技能或者某种才艺有关，例如 speech contest， 演讲比赛，而参加这种比赛的人叫做 contestant， C-O-N-T-E-S-T-A-N-T。 再来看的是 faint of heart 这个成语， faint 在这里是指昏厥或不省人事，所以 faint of heart 就是指胆小的人或者是懦夫，它的形容词是 faint-hearted， heart 字尾加上 ed， 而且中间有连字号。 faint-hearted 是指胆小的或不勇敢的，它的反义词就是 brave， 勇敢的。继续看的是 have no knowledge of something 这个动词片语。 knowledge 这个名词有知识的意思，但是在这里 knowledge 是指知道或晓得，所以 have no knowledge of something 是指对某件事情毫不知情，而且通常是不好的事。例如 most of the time the parents have no knowledge that their children are having troubles， 通常父母亲不知道他们的孩子有麻烦。 Knowledge 的后面也可以加上 that 子句。例如 ,we had no knowledge that we're going to be fired. 我们完全不知道我们会被炒鱿鱼。OK, 今天的中文讲解就到这里。Goodbye!